St. Malachy's prophetic list of the last 10 popes. Where is Pope Francis? More and more people are entering the fold of the apocalypse believers, as in, apocalypse now. That's what I had bet on, even before the eruption of Mount Pinatubo in 1991. My perception is now even stronger that the Bible's last book is unfolding, buttressed by mystical developments that include an explosion of supernatural apparitions, reviving old prophecies, and supplanting them with detailed warnings amid calls for immediate conversion. I have shared many such warnings from credible Catholic mystics of our times, but there are prophecies dated even centuries ago. One such mystical prophecy, the considerable following worldwide over the centuries, is attributed to Saint Malachy. It is one of my favorites. Saint Malachy, a monk, was born in Armagh, Ireland, in 1094 AD. He died, as he himself predicted, on November the 2nd, 1148, at Clairvaux, France. He was canonized as the first Irish saint by Pope Clement III in 1190 AD. He wrote his most spectacular prophecies on the last 10 popes, each one catalogued with an epigrammatic verse, such as Tears of the Sun. Here, I cite only his identifying last popes, although his list started with his time. The actual names of the popes were later supplied by his followers, who found uncanny conformity with the saint's epigrammatic verse, and the popes who were later elected to head the Catholic Church. First, the burning fire, referring to Pope Pius X, who was pope from 1903 to 1914. This pope showed a burning passion for spiritual renewal in the Church. Second, religion laid waste, religio depopulata, referring to Pope Benedict XV, 1914 to 1922. During his reign, communism moved into Russia, where religious life was laid waste, and World War I happened. Third, unshaken faith, Pope Pius XI, 1922 to 1939. This pope faced tremendous pressure from fascist and sinister powers in Germany and Italy, but he was an outspoken critic of communism and fascism, which enraged Hitler. Fourth, an angelic shepherd, Pope Pius XII, 1939 to 1958. This pope had an affinity for the spiritual world and received visions. He was later described as an angelic pastor. Fifth, pastor and mariner, Pope John XXIII, 1958 to 1963. Also known as pastor et nauta, or pastor and sailor. John was a pastor to the world and the patriarch of Venice, whose waterways are famous for gondolas. Sixth, flower of flowers, flows florum, Pope Paul VI, 1963 to 1978. Paul's coat of arms depicts three fleur-de-lis, corresponding to Malachy's prophecy. His coat of arms included three iris blossoms. Seventh, of the half moon, De Mediatat Lane, or From the Half Moon, Pope John Paul I, 1978 to 1978. He became Pope on August 26, 1978, when the moon appeared exactly half full. It was in its waning phase. He died the following month, soon after an eclipse of the moon. Some say he was murdered. 8th, the labor of the sun, De Mediatat Lune, Pope John Paul II, 1978 to 2005. Amazingly, Pope John Paul II was the only pope who was born both on the day of an eclipse of the sun and entombed on a day when the sun was eclipsed. Ninth, the glory of the olive. The olive is part of the insignia of the Benedictine order. Benedict XVI, whose chosen name undoubtedly rhymes with the prophecy. 10th, Peter the Roman. The 112th prophecy states, "In the final persecution of the Holy Roman Church, there will reign Petrus Romanus, who will feed his flock amid many tribulations, after which the seven-hilled city will be destroyed, and the dreadful judge will judge the people." The question is controversial Pope Francis Peter the Roman? Some say he is, for he, while being from Argentina, was at one time declared desire to be known as Bishop of Rome. Also, in the recent prophecies of Canadian mystic Father Michael Rodrigue, Francis would die a martyr, an implication that Rome, known as the seven-hilled city, would indeed be troubled someday. Saint Malachy did not see any pope beyond Peter the Roman, and this is interpreted by some as ominous amid modern Catholic mystics who confirm each other in apocalyptic times. But while there is rhyme in their apocalyptic prognostications, there is also agreement that the world is not yet ending, that the tribulations that have dawned on mankind are yet to be followed by the triumph of the Immaculate Heart of Mary that will last many more years.